can't be touched and I can't be schemed. Roll your when I'm in a mud league. 2-0, 2-0, Madden time on you suckers. Y'all can't get close, so why you wanna touch us? Cause my team is so hard, my team is legit. Madden 20, Snoop Dogg is, I get it. Jersey on my back, helmet on my head, ready to attack like that.
Down in Mississippi and New Orleans, Big Snoop Dogg out of Madden League. Your team is off the hook and you don't really want none, but if you do, come and get some. See, tell your mama and tell your daddy, and tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Tell your mama and tell your daddy, and tell the whole damn world it's Madden territory. Come get some if you want some, but you ain't bad enough, so you can't take none. I'm Big Snoop Dogg, and I'm the only one. And when it comes to Madden, all y'all fools my sons.
Bag up off me and watch you lose. Snoop Dogg is on the mic, I'm giving Madden blues. And if
hello, everybody. It's the Cup.
Okay, Coach, thank you. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is in Uptown Charlotte, North Carolina at Bank of America Stadium. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the New York Giants and the Carolina Panthers.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking team.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Coming to you.
Newton going to hand it off to McCaffrey. And that is the kind of tackling they want to see all game, as he'll lose yardage to start things out. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that'll make this a second and 13. A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. And now whistles and a flag. And I think we got a jump here. So it wasn't the line that jumped that time, the second level.
No, that's a great observation down, because most of the time it's those guys up front so eager to get off on the snap. They do it, but in this case, you're exactly right. Second level, probably because they moved up to the first level, and that hurts them.
Here's Newton. And open here is Hogan. He's got it. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. So offside's the call, and they understandably decline it.
And this is why we're seeing more and more teams hiring that one coach to the staff that's in charge of all these things. This one's minor. It's pretty easy to figure out. But all the game management stuff, trying to help out the head coach in his decision-making process.
Give him 15 there, and the Panthers have a first down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he's got about 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 25. The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. Throwing is Newton. And they got the hookup. This is Olsen. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. A good looking drive so far for the Panthers, and a first down here. They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line. So that run gets him about halfway home.
Yes, now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Full playbook. Run it again, or they can go play.
And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. A 5-yard touchdown as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that.
Graham Gano on for the extra point. And this will be good to give the Panthers a 7-0 lead. So that drives 7 plays in length. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. That's fielded in the end zone. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 10 at the 9-yard line.
Set, ready? 60 or.
On the ground, this is Saquon Barkley. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
After the penalty, they go with Barkley. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
From the 27, Manning. And he's hit and taken down. Eli sacked. The man wreaking havoc there, Gerald McCoy, the D tackle. He was trying to keep his eyes downfield. Nobody came open.
He was trying to do everything that he had been taught, right? Every bit of the technique. But if no one's open, there is no technique except make sure you hold on to the ball as you go to the ground when you're getting sacked.
Under pressure again, and down he goes again. K1 short with a sack. That's 315 pounds of man right there.
Why you would do that. It's almost guaranteed points the other way. I mean, I get it if it's a late game situation, maybe even fourth and inches, but boy, that's a huge risk to take.
Yeah, now they're set up in prime position going the other way. Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9.
Offside. Defense.
So naturally, they will decline it. They got the first down anyway on the play.
Who needs a penalty when you picked up the first down through hard work and effort anyway? First down.
To throw is Newton. And that will be caught by Moore. He's got a Panthers touchdown. Cam Newton now with 2 first quarter touchdown passes. And the Panthers, they widen their lead. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. It took them an extra look, but they found out it is a touchdown indeed. The official says this one counts. Gano the extra point, and it's now 14 to nothing. Well, that drive started with not a whole lot of real estate in front of them. In plus territory, excellent field position. 2 plays later, pay dirt. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And they'll start in a hole here as he's brought down at the 11-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that 0 off the board. And he'll lose yardage, brought down at the 32. It's a loss of a yard there, and now 2nd down. On 2nd and 11 now, Manning, he's got his man, this is Tate. The reception good for 7. It's 3rd down. A 2nd down completion got him 7. Now here's 3rd and 3. Manning now to throw. It's caught. Shepard. 13 yards. Good for a Giant 1st down. Manning going to come up on 1st and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Now a quick throw as that's complete on the hitch route. Broke through some contact, but unable to reach the 40. A gain of 6 there on 1st. To throw again on 2nd down. Manning, and he floated one out there incomplete. Cody Latimer, the intended receiver, and it's 3rd and 4. Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. Again, they'll throw with Manning. A 5-yard loss there is going to bring up fourth down. And they're going to try for the fourth down conversion. Manning in the offense staying put.
Look at me. Go.
They'll go for it. It's Manning. And they're going to bring him down. Back across midfield at the 45. The Giants go on fourth, but come up empty. And that will force a turnover on downs. Well, down two touchdowns already. I guess they felt they needed to go for it, but still early, still first half.
I think conventional wisdom says, look, as you point out, you got a whole half to play. Hang in there. Don't give up any more points in this situation. Do a little adjusting at the half and come out ready to go. But sometimes those coaches can just sense their team. Maybe they're a little flat or they need a little extra inspiration. And he decided to go for it there to try and kickstart things.
Newton on first down. That's to McCaffrey, complete. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Cam Newton with his third touchdown pass of this first half. And the Panthers, they widen their lead.
And that's another route the defenders would vote to take out of the game.
The wheel route?
Oh, without a doubt. You're just trying to move everybody in one direction. And whether it's a running back or another receiver, as they zip out on the sideline, you've got a problem on your hands.
Yeah, well, the defenders hate it there. It happened, and it resulted in a touchdown. This is fielded at the goal line. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 10 at the 9-yard line.
Let's go.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They trail here by 24 points. Got to get going soon, you'd have to think, as they come up first and 10. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. A quick throw. Here's Shepard. And they'll get him down right at around the 11-yard line. Throwing is Manning on third down. The tight end, Rhett Ellison, with it. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. We remind you that coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will be alongside. He'll have highlights and analysis from Orlando of this first half of action. That'll go for only 17 yards on the punt. And the Panthers will take over in terrific field position. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. The ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it can be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Give him 18. It's a Carolina first down. Newton will bring him up first and 10. And he's 8 for 8 now, throwing the ball to start the game. From the gun, here's Newton. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 15. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
It's been a long day for you.
So after the INT, it's Manning. That's caught by his tight end, Evan Engram. A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1. Here's Manning to throw. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Manning to burn a draw play. And they will stop him short. They get him to the ground at the 27. No first down. The Panthers going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. Here's Riley Dixon now as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. Oh, it's a wobbler here. Returning it is Moore. Officially, that'll be marked down as just a 28-yard punt. And the Panthers will take over now, 1st and 10. Cam Newton getting ready to go again on offense. He does have the one interception, Charles, but I think that's been more than offset by the three first-half touchdown passes.
I would agree with you. There is a blemish, but when you've thrown three touchdown passes to try and erase it, that's a little bit better than the ratio that all NFL coaches are seeking from their quarterbacks, and he's giving it to them.
They'll take the 3-1
every single time.
And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. A good pickup there, 21 yards. Newton now nearly perfect, 9 of 10 in this first half. It's first and 10. Now Newton, this one complete to Curtis Samuel. 11 yards and a Panther first down. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Flag comes in. This might be a free play. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
Defense.
So with the completed pass and the yardage they got, they'll decline the penalty.
So obviously, more yards on the pass completion than they would have gained with the penalty. They did the math. They did it well, and it works for them.
A chance to really cap off a big first half here as they come up on first and goal. Newton now to throw. And that will be caught by Moore. He's got a Panthers touchdown. Four touchdown passes now for Cam Newton. And the Panthers, they widen their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Extra point try, good by Gano. And a route is on here in this first half. Fielded about a yard deep. And he probably should have stayed in the end zone as he'll muster a return up to only the 14-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. And they'll get him down here at the 23. So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on second and less than a yard. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided. You want the third quarter already? No problem. Let's do it.
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one, maybe not the hard-fought battle many had hoped for. This has been blowout city thus far. But still more football to be played. Who knows what could happen? As we send you right back out to Brandon Godden.
Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. Golden Tate, his intended receiver, and it's second down. Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Off the edge, Mario Addison gets the sack. Here's Riley Dixon now, as he's on to punt for New York. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. It'll be called just a 22-yard punt. Certainly not what he wanted. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a first and 10 on the short side of the field.
Hey, let's get in them holes. 20. 66.
Now Newton on first down. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. Greg Olsen was the intended target. But it's going to be second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. He'll wind up getting three on the keeper there, but it leads to a third down. Throwing on third down, Newton. And he's got his target. That's Moore. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. 25 yards that time. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Offense.
Well, this O-line's been great. They've got the big lead, so give them a pass there, I guess.
Yeah, I would think so, because we are grading them on their performance in this game. A lot of pluses in their boxes so far.
McCaffrey following the penalty. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. They'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and it'll be a third and about 13. Third and long, it's Newton. And that will be caught by Moore. He's got a Panthers touchdown. Cam Newton with his fifth touchdown pass of the game as his guys continue to put this one out of reach.
And this is obviously quite a performance. And most of the time when we talk about someone putting a team on their back, I think we're talking about a guy who runs the football. In this case, it's a guy out wide catching it, and he's done exactly that. Truly leading his team right now towards victory.
Three touchdown catches. He's been the headliner. This fielded at the two. And he will take it back only to about the 13-yard line here.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try to put points on the board.
Pretty solid run here on first down. Almost picked up another first, but he appears to be a few inches short. On second and very short, Manning, and he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now. Manning going to try and throw on third down. And tight coverage there. It's knocked away, incomplete. Another drive comes and goes, still nothing on the scoreboard.
Yeah, and when the second half comes, you know, it's real easy to get discouraged and wonder if you're ever going to get things started. You just got to fight through it. Got to keep pounding away.
Call that a 45-yard punt, just 2 yards there on the return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And last time out, another touchdown. And I think there may be some empty seats around here by the time the fourth quarter comes around.
Yeah, I have to agree with you, because this was just about decided. But you know who benefits from all those empty seats? You and me, trying to get to the airport.
That's
the road
true.
To be fairly
that,
clear
that is
by the
one
time
positive.
We have to leave the booth.
So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, put a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. This is McCaffrey. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Tackle made that time by B.J. Hill. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11.
Offside defense.
And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
Ready? And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Cam Newton with his fifth touchdown pass of the game as his guys continue to pour it on. It's been quite the game for him individually. A trio of touchdown catches now.
So pick a route, any route. Whatever you want him to run, he's going to do it and do it well and end up in the end zone. This has really been fun to watch.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And New York set to take the field.
And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
Manning and the Giants come up now first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. From the gun, it's Manning. This is Shepard on the catch. And they're able to get this one across the 35. First down for the Giants as they pick up 12. Manning now, five straight completions here in this second half. First and 10. And this is caught. I think he got that with one hand. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of three. The completion good for three, and it's second down. The Giants on third down. They've had their troubles. Just 1 for 6. This is third and 7.
Rock it.
Shoot. Again, it's Manning. And they will finally get him to the ground as he's forced to tuck it and take the sack. Brian Burns picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
So the defense has to stay out and get one more stop. They were able to do it, forcing the incompletion.
So on their record, that goes down as a successful play. It doesn't matter how they got there, how it happened. They got it done. They're the ones that are jubilant.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard.
Let him know.
Gun.
Now Newton. Cam fighting. He lost the football. It's out.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
3 yards won't be enough here as that'll bring up fourth down. Now Graham Gano to try the Panther field goal. From the right hash and call it an even 50 yards. And this one is right down Broadway. But hang on, a flag is down. Defense. Now, if it's on the defense, they might decline it and take the points. After knocking through the field goal, here's Gano back out there now for the kickoff. That's fielded in the end zone. And nowhere to go. He'll make it back only to the 5-yard line.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
Throwing on first down is Manning. He completes it to Tate. It's a gain of 11 and a Giant first down. So a little breathing room now. First and 10 at the 17. Shotgun now for Manning. Looking deep downfield. And a scary incompletion. Almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Hey, Sam off.
Throwing again. Manning finds his tight end Ingram.
And he's able to get up here to the 26. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. The Giants on third down. It's been a problem. Just 1 for 7.